Your drive to work right now.
Yeah, unfortunately, you guys, if you are waking up or travel Highway 36 through Roseville, you're dealing with a really serious rollover crash that happened, unfortunately, at Dale Street. Both directions, eastbound and westbound, are closed off. So this line, this long, long line you are seeing, that is the traffic being diverted onto Dale Street. So again, if this is your route, you're going to want to either leave early or use one of my detours I'll suggest here in a second. But you can see both sides seeing that big slowdown. That is the only crash we are tracking. So 694 through Little Canada, through that area, or 94 are two of your options this morning. But let's get to Cece. She's on the scene there, been tracking things for us this morning. Have you learned anything new, Cece?
Yes, so we're here still on the overpass that's overlooking Highway 36 this morning. Within probably the past 10 minutes, they're starting to partially open up this lane that's right next to me, but this lane that where you have to get off on Dale Street, that lane is still shut off. Plows are diverting traffic so people can get off on Dale Street, and there has been on and off backups all morning because of that. But we want to give you the latest from the scene here. A lot of emergency vehicles have actually cleared out within the last hour, and that tent that investigators were using has come down, and it also looks like the body that was covered has been removed this morning. But within the last 10 minutes, if you can see farther down the highway there, a couple of tow trucks have been working on scene to remove that car that has been in a ditch all morning because of that serious crash that we've been talking about all morning. We have been here for a few hours and can show you some video from this morning when the scene was much more active than it is right now. You can see the scene from a traffic cam view, and then also we have video of a closer look at that car that was in a ditch, and also police securing the scene there. So we're still working to learn how this happened and why the driver went off into the ditch early this morning. But we are in contact with the Minnesota State Patrol just to get an update and an official report about what happened here this morning, guys.
All right, thanks for that, CC. Let's turn our attention now to the weather. You're looking at a live picture over Minneapolis. All clear right now in the city, but check out that radar. Some storms are forming to our south, and guys, man, tracking that.
Yeah, you know, those showers and storms will continue throughout the day, south and west. Now, for the metro, we're dry with peaks of sunshine. I would expect some increasing clouds gradually through the day, with showers making their way into the metro a little bit later on this evening, right around the evening drive. Now, that will last through the overnight hours, but on Microcast, I'm tracking the big picture with more storms possible Wednesday and Thursday, some of which could be strong to severe.
Well, now to another huge story we're following this morning. This is what a lot of store shelves look like in the baby formula aisle right now.
A big step towards fixing the problem is on hand. The FDA and manufacturer Abbott are agreeing on plans to restart production.
Jen is here with when you could see formula on the shelves again. Jen?
Yeah, and Gia, unfortunately, this isn't going to happen soon enough for families who need that formula. So here's the tentative timeline, right? Here we are, May 17th. It is going to take them about 2 weeks just to reopen that plant. That puts us end of May, but then it'll take another 6 to 8 weeks to get that formula and ship it out to store shelves. So we're looking at mid to late July before you go to the store and see formula like normal on the store shelves. So what is going on here and what can you do about it? Well, some experts say that this all started with the supply chain issues and labor shortages because of the pandemic. But then that problem got a lot worse in February of this year when those concerns about Abbott's formula came up after several babies got sick after eating it and two died. February 17th, the FDA pulled it off store shelves. By April, 31% of stores reported that they were completely out of baby formula. Now even 50% report being out in some states. Something to consider here if you do need formula is donor breast milk. There are a number of milk banks you can go to for that. One Twin Cities mom is helping donate.
I can't imagine being in that place, being nervous about being able to provide food for my baby. I wanted to be able to, I don't know, try to help other families. Start at the like community level, see what I can do.
We have that story up right now on care11.com, and it has links to those local organizations which can help you find donor breast milk. Gia.
Well, spring storms are catching up with Minnesota rivers. There's some minor flooding on the Mississippi, and this is only the beginning.
Some spots are creeping closer to flood stage. Guys here with a breakdown.
Yeah, you can check this out. I want to take you first into the metro so you can see some, areas close by. You can see Minor near Cottage Grove, Burnsville. Most of us are making out A-OK here. We're not tracking any moderate to major flooding like we're finding in some spots. And I'll be touching on that here just momentarily. But we'll zoom in. You can see a couple of flood warnings still near the Hastings area, highlighted in green. Those are still active flood warnings right now that the National Weather Service will continue throughout the day and even going into tomorrow with more rain on the way the next couple of days. Here you can see the Mississippi at Hastings again expected to reach that minor flood stage just over 16 feet. And then we'll take you a little bit further north, Minnesota River at Savage, 700 feet. So that actually still right there in the action stage, expected to reach just below or just above that action stage there in minor flooding, just around 702 feet. But I want to show you this larger outlook here because this is where you are finding some moderate flooding and some major flooding near Redwood Falls. And then again, as you get into the St. Cloud area, Mississippi at St. Cloud, Brainerd, and that far northwestern area as well near the Fargo area. More rain on the way, so I'll be tracking that out here coming up.
All right, thanks for that, Guy. Happening today, a critical program to help Minnesota homeowners opens up, and you could get thousands of dollars in aid. The program is called Home Help MN.
And if you own a home and your finances got off the track during the pandemic, you can get up to $35,000 in assistance.
You're eligible if you own a home in Minnesota and it's your primary residence and your income is below a certain income limit. For instance, if you live in a two-person home in Hennepin County, you have to make less than $93,850.
Okay, so the entire process is five steps. First, you need to gather required documents like proof of home ownership. Next, you'll create an account at homehelpmn.org and submit your application. HomeHelpMN will need to communicate with your mortgage servicer about possibly giving you assistance. Now, if everything checks out, a payment is made to your mortgage servicer. The application period ends on June 17th. 607, Alicia here from the live desk following some breaking news that just came into the newsroom. Dallas police have arrested a person in connection to a hair salon shooting. Now, this happened early last week. Three women were injured. They are expected to be okay. Investigators say the suspect is being interviewed right now. More info on the arrest is coming out later today.
Good morning. We're learning new details around that devastating shooting that happened at the supermarket behind me. Police now saying they believe the suspected shooter had actually been in town in Buffalo several months ago. I spoke with several employees at this supermarket who echoed that timeline. One woman says when she first saw images of the suspected shooter appear, she immediately recognized him, saying that he had confronted her back in March. Plus, President Biden is expected to be on the ground here later today. He will be offering a listening ear and comfort to the victims' families. We'll have that and more coming up on today.
Now for the other big headlines we're following this morning. Happening in a few hours, state leaders will discuss an investigation into the Minneapolis Police Department. Lawmakers on two Minnesota House committees will meet. They'll focus on the state's Department of Human Rights report on MPD. The report released last month shows the Minneapolis Police Department engaged in a pattern of illegal racial discrimination for a decade. If you're starting to grill out, heads up, there's a tick that may make you allergic to red meat. It's called the Lone Star tick. The Minnesota Department of Health says it's very rare in Minnesota. If you're protecting yourself from every other kind of tick, you'll be safe from this one too. Over 1,700 Minnesota school buses will be equipped with cameras to catch speeders who blow by stop arms. And get this, violators will be the ones paying for the program. The state legislature just passed a bill that increases the penalty to $300. Of that, $250 will go directly to the school districts where the violation occurred. The